Good morning. Today I'm going to read from a book by a friend of mine. I have a good story about this guy. When I was first published, I got a, I guess it was probably an email from someone who wrote for a magazine called January Magazine. It was an online magazine. And this guy interviewed me. He was the very first person to ever interview me as a published writer. And he was in the Army. He was stationed in Alaska at the time. And eventually we got to meet in person. It turned out he was he had a strong Montana connection. His wife is from Darby, I think. I'm not sure. I probably have that wrong. And David grew up in Montana in Wyoming for part of his childhood, and just had a very strong connection to this part of the country. So eventually they moved here and they now live in Helena. So his first book, Fobbit, came out 10 years ago. It's been compared to Catch 22, and it's just a wonderful book. And David is someone who has done a lot for other writers. He does a blog that, if you haven't heard of it, you should check it out. It's called The Quivering Pen, which is my favorite name ever for a blog. And he interviews writers. He talks about his favorite books. He provides links to other writers. He does just a lot of interesting things, and has been a very wonderful champion for a lot of his fellow writers. Plus, he's just damn good. So, his second book was also good, and I'm, for some reason, I can't think of the name of it all of a sudden, but it's Fobbit is more of a satire of war. It's about his time. He was stationed in Iraq. The second book is more of a serious book, and I really love that book. But this one is his first. They were Fobbits because at the core they were nothing but marshmallows. Crack open their chests, and in the space where their hearts should be beating with a warrior's courage and selfless regard, you'd find a pale, gooey center. They cowered like rabbits in their cubicles, busied themselves with PowerPoint briefings to avoid the hazard of Baghdad's bombs, and steadfastly clung white-knuckled to their desks at Forward Operating Base Triumph. If the FOB was a mother's skirt, then these soldiers were pressed hard against the pleats, too scared to venture beyond her grasp. Like the shy, hairy-footed hobbits of Tolkien's world, they were reluctant to go beyond their shire, bristling with rolls of concertina wire at the borders of the fob. After all, there were goblins in turbans out there, or so they convinced themselves. Supply clerks, motor pool mechanics, cooks, mail sorters, lawyers, trombone players, logisticians, fobbits one and all. They didn't give a shit about appearances. They were all about making it out of Iraq in one piece. Of all the fobbits in the U.S. Military Task Force headquarters at the western edge of Baghdad, Staff Sergeant Chance Gooding Jr. was the fobbitest. With his neat pressed uniform, his lavender vanilla body wash, and the dust collected around the barrel of his M16 rifle, he was the poster child for the stay back, stay safe soldier. The smell of something sweet radiated off his skin as if he bathed in gingerbread. Gooding worked in the public affairs office of the 7th Armored Division, headquartered in one of Saddam Hussein's marbled palaces. His PAO days were filled with sifting through reports of significant activities and then writing press releases about what he'd found. His job was to turn the bomb attacks, the sniper kills, the sucking chest wounds, and the dismemberments into something palatable, ideally something patriotic, that the American public could stomach as they browsed the morning newspaper with their toast and eggs. No one wanted to read, "A soldier was vaporized when his patrol hit an improvised explosive device, his flesh thrown into a nearby tree where it draped like Spanish moss." But the generals and colonels of the 7th Armored Division all agreed that the folks back home would appreciate hearing, "A soldier paid the ultimate sacrifice while carrying out his duties in Operation Iraqi Freedom." Gooding's weapons were words. His sentences were missiles. That is Fobbit. It's also in paperback. I happen to have a really cool British version here, but that's by my friend David Abrams. Check it out. Have a great day.